This is a holiday story. I think it's fitting. So before my husband and I moved to New York, we had this whole other life for us in Tulsa, Oklahoma, where we were living. We were both full-time teachers. We had benefits. We had teacher retirement. We had a paid-for car. Like, we just had this very nice little life with a bow on it. And then in 2006, something happened. I won an internet dance contest, like you do, and that had me perform on Broadway with the cast of Hairspray. Thank you. And I'm not gonna lie, guys, there is something super seductive about dancing around in giant wigs where you're like, I should be doing this all the time. I'm gonna take out my life savings and quit my job. And that's what I did. Lest you think, oh, she didn't have a plan. I had a plan. Step one, become a famous Broadway performer. Natch. Two, have my husband become a New York Times best-selling author because he had a blog. And like the time frame I gave for this to happen, literally what I thought this could happen in, I was like, that'll take like a month. Give it a month. Like we're going to lock that down in the first week, and then we have like buffer weeks. So I'm going to save you some details here. Fast forward 6 months, I'm sitting on my futon, because that's where sadness lives, and I'm hanging out with my good friend Depression, and I have never been more miserable and literally just so broke in my entire life. Fresh vegetables, I don't know what those are anymore. I can't afford them. The only thing that we eat every single night, the only thing we can afford is beans and rice. Every single night. Beans and rice, beans and rice. And we're starting to get that real nice, doughy, kind of bloated, starchy face going on. And I thought that was a low point. I thought, no. Hand to God, sitting on my futon, this mouse comes out from behind the stove, roots in the trash. There's no food there. Jumps out and then just goes, just like, oh, you sad country mice, you sad sacks. Like, and that just tipped the scales. I was like, I have to get out of this apartment. I have to get out of here. I'm going insane. Couldn't afford to go anywhere, but I knew that that night there was this tree lighting ceremony in Bryant Park, and they were going to have singers and like skaters. And so I said to my husband, I was like, do you want to come with me to go see the singers and the skaters? And he's heterosexual, so he said no. So I was like, fine, I'm gonna go by myself. And I make my way, and just every step that I'm taking to get there, I'm just getting angrier and angrier. Like, this gamble didn't pay off. I'm so stupid, I ruined my life. I was like, well, at least this event is gonna like cheer me up for a while. Wrong. I get there, and it is just that mass that of like New York people who are like, free event, you know? And it's just wall to wall. And I just start muscling my way through it, shoulder to shoulder. I'm getting through, and I get stuck in the middle, and I can't see anything. And it's so close. There's this woman behind me, and every time she moves her hand, it just like is rubbing on my ass. And then I yell to her, if you don't stop what you're doing back there, I'm going to start charging you. And she's like, whoa, 'tis the season. I'm that person in the crowd. There's this older guy in front of me, a very cute older gentleman. He keeps turning around looking at me, and I was like, what is this guy's problem? Finally, he turns around and he goes, excuse me, miss, I noticed you're not having a good time. And I was like, eh. And then he goes, well, would you like my spot? I can see everything. And I was like, yeah, I don't want, because I'm committed to being an asshole now, you know? So he goes, no, take my spot. And he pushes me up, and even though it's only one person difference, I can see everything. I see the singers and the skater, and like it really is that like one in like only in New York moments where you're like, this is nice, like this is a magical thing. And after a while, I turn to him and I say, I'm sorry, you know, thank you, I have to leave. And he's like, oh, I'm leaving myself. And we make our way back through the crowd. And right before I leave, I thank him again, and he goes, miss, can I just tell you one last thing? I was like, sure. He goes, I just want to tell you that I think you are a very beautiful woman. And guys, it was like the first nice thing anyone had said to me since I moved to New York. And like my puffy rice face, I was like, thank you. Thank you for saying I'm beautiful. And then he goes, and I'd like to offer you $100,000 to sleep with you. What? Yes, $100,000 to sleep with you. And I was like, it's a Christmas miracle. But in the world. worst possible packaging. Like, here I thought he was, like, an adorable shoe cobbler, not, like, the ghost of Christmas prostitution, you know? And then I, when I look at him, I just see, like, the beans and rice dancing in his eyes. They're like, do it, do him, do this dude. And then I have the proverbial, like, devil and angel. It's like, take the money, take the money. And then it's like, no, no, remember that thing your mother used to tell me. I was like, yes, what's the thing my mom used to tell me? Oh, yes, don't be a whore. Don't be a whore. I just want to stop here for a second. I want to really break this down for you guys, okay? I want you to really think about this. $100,000. Do you know what you can buy with $100,000? Lettuce. Fresh fruit. You like I don't know. That might not be a lot of money. You might be secret millionaires who come to open mics on Wednesday nights. I don't know. You might be. But it was a lot of money to me. It still is. And like, as this is going in my head, he's just layering it on thicker and thicker. He's telling me, we're going to go to this hotel, and we're going to get the penthouse suite and room service all night, and I'm an excellent lover. And I was like, it's like Indecent Proposal, the holiday version, but like with less sexy casting. All I know is that I have to get out of here. And I tell him, I was like, I have to go. Like, I love my husband. I love my husband. But I also really like money. So I tell him, I was like, I'm sorry, I have to go. And he goes, well, are you walking to the subway? I said, yes. And he goes, well, let me accompany you there. And I was like, oh, he's a gentleman too. So we're walking to the subway, and he's talking to me, and we're actually having like a pleasant conversation for him being a sexual like predator, but like a nice conversation. And we get to the subway, and he goes, is there anything else I can say to change your mind? And I don't know why I said this next thing, but I go, listen, if we're both here next year and we happen to see each other, like, I don't even know why I started this. Like, I wanted it to be like, you know, like a Sleepless in Seattle. I'll meet you on the Empire State Building. But it was like, really what it was like, okay, if like in a year I'm still broke and you're still horny, like, we'll lock this down. Like, that's what it was. He takes my hand, kisses it, he walks off, I get on the subway, and on the ride home, I'm just trying to wrap my head around what happened. I get home, I open the apartment door, my husband's there, and I go, you are not gonna believe the night I just had. And I tell him everything, every detail, every little thing. And that's when I learn, oh, you don't tell your spouse everything. You don't tell your spouse everything. You don't do it. Long pause. He finally looks up and he speaks and he goes, so like, how was he gonna pay you? Like, with a check? Thank you guys. Thank you, Philip, for having me.
Great story. Oh. And that is Leslie Goshko. Leslie, you didn't even plug your show.
Come on
up and plug your show. Okay. You got to do that. She has a really funny show over at KGB a few blocks from here.
Oh, thank you.
My last name is Goshko, so the show is called Sideshow Goshko. It's all true stories like the one you just heard, kind of these odd, bizarre stories that happen to people. January, we're always the fourth Thursday of every month at KGB, and January 22nd is our six-year anniversary. So it's going to be a big blowout. And then we play trivia, and we give out a bottle of wine, and since it's our sixth year, we give out one for every year, so we're giving away six bottles of wine. So everyone get real drunk. Thank you.